Hi there. Welcome to another Culture Mavens. I'm so happy to be here with Rabbi Susan Nanus. I'm Tom Teicholz. And Susan, I know that you've got some really exciting films to tell us about.
Well, yes. I mean, this film, didn't it win the Golden Globe also, Nomadland? Or was it,
Yes, it did. It won for Best Picture.
So Best Nomadland drama. Is a beautiful film starring Frances McDormand. The nomads they're talking about are people sort of on the edge of society, mainly older people, and they live in their vans and they sort of travel from place to place all over the country doing part-time work. Besides Frances McDormand, the three other stars of the movie are real nomads that she got to play themselves. So it's fascinating, and I highly recommend it. It's gentle. Nothing terrible happens. It's just a beautiful portrait of a life on the fringe of society that we would never know about. The other film I found is called Incitement, and it won the Ophir Award for Best Film. That's the Israeli Academy Awards, and it's about the assassination of Yitzhak Rabin, told from the point of view of the boy who assassinated him and his fanaticism and how he twisted the Torah. So those are two films for this week that I highly recommend. You have some stuff too, don't you?
Yes. I watched this film called Sound of Metal, which is a very unusual film that stars Riz Ahmed, who was in The Night Of, and he plays a drummer in a speed metal band who loses his hearing. And he's also a former addict. And it's about his struggle to reconcile himself with his hearing loss. And it doesn't necessarily build a resolve, but it really is a portrait of a person you wouldn't otherwise come into contact with. And it's quite a great performance.
And don't you have some documentaries that you really like?
Oh, yes. Thank you for reminding me. So on Apple Plus, there is a documentary about Billie Eilish. You know, Billie Eilish is a local girl who lives on the east side of LA. Her older brother is her producer and her band, essentially. And they started making songs, which they put up on SoundCloud, one of which, Ocean Eyes, became a hit. She won all four categories of the Grammys. This documentary kind of tracks her during the making of her first album. You really see someone experiencing this phenomenal success at such a young age, where she's still living at home. Her mother and her father are still part of her life. And it's interesting. It's worth watching. The other one that I want to recommend is a documentary about Pelé, the very famous Brazilian soccer player. And although it also is not as deep and about his personal life, it does give you a sense of how he put Brazil on the map and transformed soccer and his amazing personality. He's one of those individuals like Muhammad Ali who transcends all sports and becomes a national or international ambassador.
Allen versus Pharaoh. I don't know if you've started. I've been watching it about Woody Allen and Mia Farrow and the accusation of Dylan Farrow against Woody Allen for sexual abuse that he's been denying for 25 years. So it's made by Amy Ziering, who's an amazing filmmaker who's made some very powerful documentaries. And I don't think she would make a documentary on something she didn't believe in. So I've started watching it. It's kind of a guilty pleasure, but it's riveting with a lot of footage and interviews. And that's something else if you're looking to be distracted. Also yeah. On that note, The Braid, they have a new show called Family Matters. It's for men and women. It's comedy. It's firsthand original writing. It really focuses on writers and brand new writing, and they're wonderful. And also, one more thing, speaking of shows, Hershey Felder, who's an amazing, you know, musician, singer, writer, actor. Apparently, he's been living in Florence for a while, and he's been doing these elaborate, incredible one-man shows on different famous individuals who are attached to music. George Gershwin alone, which means he will be singing, playing, and acting out George Gershwin, and Beethoven, meaning he will be acting Beethoven and playing his music. And don't you have some dance?
Yes, I continue to.
People who love your comments about ballet.
So I continue to go down the dance rabbit hole. In Her Hands, it's about Camille Claudel and Rodin.
Oh.
And Camille Claudel was a sculptor who was also Rodin's lover. And he dropped her and she ended up in an insane asylum. Her story is danced by Natalia Osipova. And she's one of the greatest ballerinas and it's really worth watching. Also, companies are starting to plan a spring and summer seasons. And so ABT had for the first time their junior company, the ABT Studio Company, performing on stage that are quite nice and a good way to learn who are going to become the next generation of great ballet stars. New York City Ballet is just launching their digital season. And then David Hallberg, who I've talked about before, who's an American dancer, has retired from dancing, but is now the artistic director of the Australian Ballet. And it's now summer in Australia, and Australia being further ahead in their vaccine and COVID fight than we are, for the first time had the Australian Ballet performing again on stage with an audience. You can watch it for 3 days, and it's a program of a number of different dances, but they're about to put their season online. You can watch some offerings for free and then later on for pay of the Australian Ballet in David Halberg's first season. And he's going to have a new commission from Pam Tanowitz, who's a really interesting American choreographer. She's done something new for them, which I'm very much looking forward to seeing.
Tom, have you heard about this immersive Van Gogh exhibit that's coming to LA?
Yes, and I very much want to go. So I look forward to reviewing it for all of you in a future episode.
It's like you go into a space and there's Van Gogh art and paintings projected on the walls, and it's like you're in the Van Gogh world. But I want to say that it's already sold out. This is going to be live. It's not going to be, you know,
right. And it's socially distanced. They have circles where you stand and move to so that you're not in close contact with other people.
The reason I want to mention it is it already sold out until next September.
Really?
Yes.
Well,
tickets like today.
I won't be shocked if they extend it.
Well, they've already extended it, but just saying it's sold out until next September. So it hasn't even opened, but I wouldn't normally mention it, but I think it should be on people's radar. And also on people's radar, they just should go to, again, our greatly admired Stryker Center at Temple Emmanuel, where this month, it's Women's History Month. Hillary Clinton will be speaking on March 11th. They'll do a program on American Jewish matriarchs on March 15th, and the notorious RBG, Ruth Bader Ginsburg, on March 18th.
Speaking of important women, I just read, and I highly recommend, Justice Sonia Sotomayor's memoir, My Beloved World. She really is a special person who's had quite a journey, and she writes very movingly about her diabetes diagnosis and what she underwent to sort of lead a beyond normal life, growing up in the South Bronx, her trips to Puerto Rico, where her family was from, going to Princeton. And she has a very interesting discussion about affirmative action and what those opportunities are like. and the resentment that you face as a result of it. And then there are other things in it that are really surprising and funny. She was a prosecutor in the DA's office in Manhattan, which not a lot of Supreme Court justices were former prosecutors. And then she went into private international legal practice, where her clients included the Fendi family and the Ferrari company.
Wow.
And she got to drive Ferraris around Italy. And I love those parts of the book. And My Beloved Country is a really wonderful book. And increasingly, as Sonia Sotomayor takes up the fight that Ruth Bader Ginsburg led for many years for what we think of as a women's rights and liberal rights, it's really worth getting to know her.
Well, I think we're going to end on this and let people know that in 2 weeks, at our next Culture Mavens, it's going to be an all-women's program, women mystery writers, women performers.
In Jewish history.
Oh, we'll talk about women in Jewish history. I am teaching a class for anyone who's interested on 10 famous Jewish women in history that you never heard of. I found some fabulously interesting women through the millennia, so you can join me for that. And we'll wish you a Shabbat Shalom and a beautiful week, and see you next time.
See you. Bye.